Good afternoon, students. In the previous class, we were discussing the basic concepts of tax. You know well, basic concepts of taxes are nothing but the basic names. The basic terms are used in the tax. Right? Taxes alone, income tax alone, one of the aspects of the particular name is put in there. Our particular names are called the basic concepts. Basic names of the taxes and the same concept we had come across with the first one assessment year and the second one is the previous year and even in a previous class we had discussed about the provisions relating to the previous year. Right? After the provisions relating to the previous year we had discussed. And today in this class, we will move further in relation to the basic concept. Third basic concept is the assessing. Assessing, section 2, subsection 7. Section 2 as 2 and subsection 7 of the Income Tax Act 1961 speaks about the assessing. Assessing are those persons, a person by whom income tax or any other sum of money payable under the Income Tax Act 1961. Assessing means what? Assessing is a person by whom income tax or any sum of money is payable to the tax department or to the government here. That person is called as an assessing. ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೆ ತುಂಬತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಪೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಯಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇನ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೂಮ್ Any proceedings has taken for the assessment of his income or loss or the amount of refund to him. That means here, for any person, the income tax proceedings are made. That person is called as a assessor. Means what? The income tax proceedings has taken in the sense here, the assessment of income made. Assessment of loss or refund of any amount to any particular person is made by the tax department. That person is called as an assessing. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟ ಹಾಗೆ ಆತನ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಆತನಿಗೆ ಆದಂತಹ ಲಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಮತ್ತೆ ಆತನಿಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ರಿಫಂಡ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ನ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ನಾವು ತಿಳಿದೇವೆ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡೀಮ್ಡ್ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಓಕೆ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ನಾ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಸಸ್ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಪೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ Assessing is a person in respect of whom the income tax proceedings are taken. Income tax proceedings are taken in the sense calculation of tax, calculation of amount, calculation of losses. These all proceedings are taken in favor of any person. That person is called as an assessor. Next, deemed assessing. Idharle assessiyale next concept of deemed assessing. What is this one? Deemed assessee. Okay. So deemed assessee is a person who can be assessed on the income of some other person. Deemed assessee andre deemed assessees are those person that person will be assessed in the income of the some other person. Andre yavade obba vyaktiya aadayada saluvagi innobba vyaktiyana hesarana innobba vyaktina assessee assessment maartta idre aa vyaktige naavu deemed assessee anta kareeve. For example, ya minor. Minor is a person who is not capable to make any contract. ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುವ ಹಾಗೆ ಮೈನರ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಯೋಗ್ಯನಾಗಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಎಲಿಜಿಬಲ್ ಆಗಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಅ ಮೈನರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಇಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಮೈನರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಇಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 10 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ಆನ್ ಇಯರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕೇಪಬಲ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕೇಪಬಲ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. So now, what the income tax is going to make in the name of minor, some other persons are accessory of called guardian. What is that one? Guardian. Right? Andre minor ne irukku deemed accessory andre oppa vyakti income na calculation maaru saluvagi aa vyakti hesaralli innobba vyaktiyana calculation maaruvantadu aa reethiyagi naavu innobba vyaktiyana calculation maadre adakke naavu deemed assessee anta kareyutteevi. Andre innobba vyaktiya income na calculation maaruva saluvagi aa innobba vyakti hesaranna sesuvantadu right, that person is called as a deemed assessee. Example minor. Minor ku assess maadikagilla yakandre minor sanna irutane aprapta vayasu inda kadime vayasu irutane hagagi aatrige yen gottagudilla aadre aatrige income ide adakke minor na paravagi minor na badalige aatana guardian major irutare avarana assessment maaruvantu inda income of some other person is some other person's assessed. Okay, in the income of some person, some other persons are assessed. That's what we are saying, the deemed assessed. A person who can be assessed in the income of the some other person. Like kelavu ashtu vyaktigalu income tax assessment madutte aa assessment madlikke kaarana entu andre aa innobba vyaktiya aadayada adiyalli avarana assessment maaruvantadu adakke naavu kelavu. Second, another example ini padabodu. First example alli innada example non resident, non resident of India. Hesare helta ide is a residing outside India having income, having income in India. Okay. Now see, the person is residing outside India, but he has some income in India. Maybe property or land, maybe out of that income is arising. But that person, our vyakti orally, very recently, that property is in India. That is income banta. Iga ata adi kani iwa property la ille income ille iga ki a income na iwa. So deemed assessed. So in the assessing, one more point, assessing in department. Assessing in default. This is very important. Assessing in default in a sense, whenever some person has a responsibility to do under the Income Tax Act, but they fail to do those acts, then they are the responsible persons here, and those persons are called as a assessee in default. Andre, income tax na tegekondaga, income tax ondashtu vyaktigalige kelavondu work ana kottirutte. Aa work na avaru maadare yenu fail aadu andre avaranne yenu matte neeve assessee anta heli avaranna default aagi avaranna assessee anta tegekondu. Adakke naavu kelidu assessee in default. Example na tegekondona, example owners of the company. What is the responsibility of the owners of the company? Whenever the salary is paid to the employees of the organization, if the employees' incomes are increasing or exceeding the slab rate, right? Exceeding the slab rate, right? Oba employee company owner idane, aata worker galige salary kodu. Salary na koduvantaha sandarbhadalli aa vyaktiya worker na salary 7,50,000 kinta jaasti idre aata TDS maadbeku. Tax deducted expenses anta kelthare TDS na maadi cut tax na cut maadi salary kodabeku. Ondu vele aa employer enadru tax na cut maadade salary kodutare avaga employee alli responsible person aagudala, employee assessee aagudala. Yaar antare cut maadidaro owner. Owner kelsa adu tax na cut maadu. Aa tax na cut maadina andre automatically default in the sense here, when person is responsible for doing any work under the IT, but he fails to do it, then that person is called as an assessee in default. Then, so when some persons are responsible to do some work in the IT Act, but those persons are fails to do that work, then those persons are called as a assessee in default, right? Owner example kote salary kodbekadre avaru slab rate inta salary jaasti hogta idre varshadalli tax ana cut maadi en maadbeku salary kodbeku. Tax cut maadodane yenadru fail aadre avaga yaar responsible assessee. Adakke yaar responsible owner e owner ane en kittnavu assessee in default. In default anta tappidda anta heli artha. Next term, the basic term we are discussing here, person, section 2, subsection 13. Section 2, subsection 31 of the IT Act speaks about the person. Person means, so actually we think here person in the sense one person. It's the wrong word. The term person includes so many concepts. Individual individual person. The concept called individual is separate and person is separate. I got the point, right? Person in the sense, it is the inclusive of individual. Person is individual of the rarely. Are individual is the alvaru vyaktigalu bartare endu. So person, the term person includes so many concepts here, so many terms here. The person includes first one, A. Individual, right? So individual in the sense, now we are the natural human beings is included is called as an indivisible. Right? Male, female, right? Minor child, lunatics, and all persons are to be called as an indivisible. Vyaktigal, naisargika vagi, janamana padantaro, male athwa female agirabodu athwa minor child agirabodu sanna vyaktigal agirabodu sanna mugu agirabodu athwa lunatics puttala agirabodu ivarellarku naavu enu kettidive aa indivisible anta heli karitaru. So the person, term person includes the first concept here, indivisible. Second one, HUF. HUF is also included in the concept called person, Hindu undivided family. HUF business, it is a business which is run by the family members, and the karta is the head of the family, and the remaining family members are being called as a successors. Kada successors anta naavu helta idivi. So andre Hindu undivided family kuda edara bhaga person ada bhaga. Next, so HUF includes here ancestors, wives, sons, wives, unmarried daughters, etc. Next, now see here, person term includes the company also. We know a company, nothing but it is an association of so many persons. And this association of persons, what they made here? They made a contribution of money to the common stock. With the help of same money, they are going to make a business activities. And after making some activities, they are going to earn a profit out of that. That profit will be shared among the associates. That kind of an organization is called as a company. Company is also a part of the person. Person, only person in the concept only, yes, term artificial person, artificial judicial person. Up. Artificial judicial persons. So artificial judicial persons, nothing but here, these are the entities, but these are not a natural person, but they have a separate entity in the eyes of law. Then artificial judicial persons artha enappa andre ivuga natural persons alla aadre kanoonina drushtiyalli avugalige tannade aadantha ondu astitva idu. So these are not a natural person, but they have a separate existence in the eyes of law. Avada eyes of law avugalige navu kittidivi artificial judicial persons. Like example agi university ante ikkolabo, university is a university artificial judicial person. Bar council aagirabodu, bar council aagirabodu. Okay, this is what. So artificial judicial persons are not a natural person, but they have their existence or an entity in the eyes of law, separate entity in the eyes of law. That's what we are saying, the artificial judicial person. Next one, Z, association of person. AOP, association of person. So association of persons means what? Two or more person who join for a common purpose with a view to earn an income does not constitute partnership firm, may include non-individual corporate company. Right? Association of person. Association of person means two or more persons are going to create an association. Right? Ippala thwa ippala gintan the jasthi vektiva tammale vandu gumpana maatukare. A association of common purposes na muttu vasalvagi vandu gumpana maat. Right? A common purpose enagirthe avaru uddesha profit na gasodo matte ee common purpose partnership na valagondilla adu company na valagondu. Hoda association of so many person, association of person andre is not limited to certain, it is not limited to certain number. Partnership is limited adu company is limited adike company terms na valagondide partnership na valagondide. So association of person is nothing but it's a group of so many persons who have created this group for a common intention, that is to earn a profit. That association of person is also part of the persons. H. Now body of individual. B O. Body of individual. So body of individual. Now I can say two or more individuals are going to make a work association. Two or more individual who carry some activity with a view to earn an income. It consists only means yam ibbaratwa ibbarinda jaatinda vyaktigalu tammade aadantha avu gumpana maadi alli tav income na adakke avanti body aagutte nenagidagaveko illi kevala individual ga group irutte individuals group irutte aadre illi it's a group of individual irabodu अथवा कंपनी पर्सन और कंपनी को सो बॉडी ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स नथिंग बट टू आर मोर पर्सन्स हु आर गोइंग टू मेक अ वन ग्रुप हियर विद अ इंटेंशन, कॉमन इंटेंशन टू अर्न अ प्रॉफिट. दैट बॉडी ऑफ इंडिविजुअल इज कॉल्ड एज अ. Now see here, these all things are included and we are calling that concept as a person. If all concept are not included, now we concept to get that we persons. Have you got the point here? So person is not an individual, keep in your mind. Person, the term person includes so many terms here, right? It's all terms are included. It's all terms together we are calling the concept called, we call the concept called persons. Okay? So next. This is the persons. Okay. In our next class, we will discuss some more concepts relating to the